In this video, I will be discussing what we should do as women to maintain fit and healthy and keep diseases at bay. So first and foremost, we need to stop smoking, reduce or stop taking alcohol and any other substance abuse problem. Exercise and good nutrition go a long way. Both these things together will help in not only fighting against diabetes, obesity, hypertension, stroke, but also a lot of cancers. Next, in young women, we should also go for HPV vaccination, which along with routine pap smears helps in preventing cervical cancer. All women should learn self-breast examination and do a self-breast examination at least once in 3 months. We should talk to a doctor about our risk factors for diseases such as breast cancer, uterine cancer, ovarian cancer, family history of diabetes, hypertension, so that there can be a structured follow-up program for all of us. It is recommended to go for a mammography once a year after 40 years of age to check for any low risk or beginning of a breast cancer. And also go for pap smears, which are nothing but the cells from the cervix are sent for microscopy. This should be done at least once in 3 years. So speak to a doctor about your risk factors and what kind of a screening program would help you, and go for annual health checkups accordingly. And I hope this video helps you to feel more confident and at ease and not become overwhelmed and anxious with all the information available to us nowadays.
Happy International Women's Health Day to all the women out there. On this occasion, I would like to talk about the maintenance of a good eye health. Vision is an integral part of one's life, and maintaining it is an utmost important. In this era of increased trend in diabetes and hypertension, it's necessary that people living with diabetes and hypertension get your eye checked every yearly to rule out hypertensive retinopathy and diabetic retinopathy, which is one of the cause for blindness. At the time of diagnosis of hypertension and diabetes, make sure that you meet your eye doctor at the same time to rule out any eye diseases. In a menopausal women who have symptoms of irritation or gritty sensation, or who are more prone for ocular inflammation, all these are because of the decreased tear production, which is because of the decreased estrogen levels. So make sure that you cut the cycle of dryness by meeting your eye doctor and getting your dry eye evaluated and treated for the same. Cataract is the clouding of the normal clear lenses, which is also one of the cause of preventable blindness. So make sure that after 50 years, you see your eye doctor regularly to keep in check and detect cataract or any other eye disease at the earliest. To all the women out there, especially girls and women of childbearing age who are more prone for vitamin A deficiency that might lead to nyctalopia or say night blindness, make sure that you are eating right. That means your diet should include a lot of vegetables and fruits that contain vitamin A, carotene, lutein, etc., which is good for your eyes. Okay. May being the month of women's health, make sure that you make your eye health a priority and schedule an appointment for comprehensive eye checkup. Stay home, stay safe, and stay healthy.
To look and feel good at any age, you have to make some smart choices. Some few tips I can give you. First, have a well-balanced diet. Second, stay away from risky habits. For example, cigarette. If someone is smoking, keep some distance from such people. Thirdly, women of age 40 or above should do a mammogram yearly. And of course, the most important, exercise. Exercise gives you more flexibility, strengthens your muscles, and builds up your endurance. At the same time, it also helps digestion, improves your skin, and also delays your osteoporosis risk. So stay safe, stay healthy.